This is the Alpine Fault, and it's where the Pacific Plate and the Australian Plate meet. A fault is a break in the Earth's crust, where one side of the fault is moving relative to the other, but it happens in a short, sharp movement during an earthquake. So this light green rock is the Pacific Plate, and it's been dragged up from depth over many millions of years, and it's sitting on top of the Australian Plate. So this is the Alpine Fault, an active tectonic plate boundary right before our very eyes. The Alpine Fault is an 800 kilometre long structure, and it carves its way right down the western side of the Southern Alps in the South Island of New Zealand. And the Alpine Fault is of concern to us because it has the potential to release a magnitude 8 earthquake sometime in the next few years. So the paleoseismic evidence on the Alpine Fault tells us that over the last 8,000 years there have been 26 magnitude 8 earthquakes. Those events have happened incredibly regularly through time. So given that the Alpine Fault has a long history of generating these big earthquakes, it's highly likely that we'll have another one within our lifetime. During an Alpine Fault earthquake, we'd expect horizontal movement of about 8 or 9 metres and vertical uplift of 2 or 3 metres. The Alpine Fault is a very long fault, and when there's an Alpine Fault rupture, it's going to break the surface right along that length. So we're expecting a 400 kilometre rupture of the Alpine Fault. Now, where you get surface rupture is where the most damage is done. So if there's a road, a bridge, or a community living across the Alpine Fault itself, it's going to be really badly affected. It's going to have a very broad impact across the South Island. Our highway network, our power, communications, all of our critical infrastructure will be really badly affected by this Alpine Fault event. When we have an Alpine Fault earthquake, it's really important that people are prepared beforehand, because the more prepared you can be, the more comfortable your life is going to be afterwards. So we all have a part to play in earthquake preparedness.